Sport on Kevin TV.
Good evening and welcome to All About Sport on CavanTV.com, coming to you live from Top of the Town Studios here in Cavantown, sponsored by drumlinmedia@gmail.com. I'm Louise O'Reilly. Joining me on tonight's show is the champions from Cootehill Celtic, who have just recently won the Cavan Hurling Championship here in Cavan. And later on in the show, please stay tuned because I will be doing live on air my ice bucket challenge. So make sure to hang around for that. So gentlemen, we'll come to you first before I'm ready to get very, very wet and get covered in water. But joined by Seamus Hughes, the manager, and Aiden Fitzpatrick. So thank you for joining us on All About Sport. So guys, Seamus, you're the manager.
Yeah.
Congratulations. When's the last time Cootehill Celtic won the Cavan Senior Championship, or have they ever?
Well, they've won it all right, but to be honest with you, there's different dates, but it's at least 50 years. It's at least gone back to the 60s, and possibly. They would have had success in the 30s, but it would have been the 30s and the 60s. So, you know, it's a long wait. It's over 50 years, no matter what way you go.
Brilliant. You must have been delighted. You know, worked very hard. Aiden, you're the captain.
That's right.
And you've been playing for how many years did you say you've been playing with?
31 years.
Long, long time. A long time. You know, you never give up or, you know, lost heart. You stuck in there.
I still haven't given up either.
Yeah.
No, 31 years, my first Ronald Hill jersey. Then I played a different club since that.
Yeah.
And it's great to win a championship with Cootehill.
Brilliant. Yeah. So, in regards, you were playing Ballymachugh, mm-hmm. and obviously in the final, what was the game like itself?
Well, it was a replay, and the first match was probably a higher quality game than the first game, because on the second day, it just happened to be a bad day weather-wise, and there's not much you can do about that, especially with hurling and that, but both games are very good games, and we've good crowds at both matches and that. So, you know, obviously, it was our first championship as a group of players, first senior championship. So, you know, it's nice to play a great game and win a great game, but like winning is the most important at this moment.
Exactly.
In time,
you know, yeah. So. Obviously, Owen Morris has done great work with kind of promoting hurling in the county. Aiden, is hurling something you've always been involved with? I mean, have you been a dual player? Would you play Gaelic football, or where did it all begin for you?
Well, hurling came first, and I did play football. I didn't start playing football until I was about 19. I played on the 14. Hurling was strong back then in Cootehill, but we won on the 14 championship and league, and played on the 16, but then it faded away. There was no Owen Morrissey back then to keep it driving on.
Yeah.
It just faded away. So then I played football. At Owen Morrissey's done a great work. Like, you know, there's a big pile of ice coming behind us.
That's right.
From the age of 22 down to 11 or down to 6. There's could be 150 fellas in Cootehill playing hurling. So,
Is that the biggest numbers you've seen in your time?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
So then I suppose the celebrations went well. Seamus and Aiden, lots of celebrating.
Lots of celebrating. stopped and obviously in Tullavane on the way home. We've a good few kill lads on the team, then obviously back to Cootehill and good celebrations around the town and that. And obviously with the young lads, you know, it's great for them, but especially for the likes of Aiden and that, you know what I mean? That's been waiting so long and that, you know what I mean? And for the Horan people in the area, you know, for them, the people that have been added, you know, there would have been people that would have been involved in the club, say, from the 80s to the 90s, and I suppose the club really grew again from 2000s on, like, so, you know, for those people, you know, that have put in the hard slog with these young fellas, you know what I mean, to bring them to this level now, it was fantastic, you know, fantastic.
For them, to kind of reap the benefits and the rewards. And just to have something to celebrate like that, when, you know, they've probably been involved themselves and played and maybe never had the chance to see, I suppose, the cup come home. You're obviously in preparation now for the first round of the Ulster
championship, Aiden. So how's preparations coming along?
It's going along steady. We're just getting into it now. We've got about 5 weeks. So we have a challenge game arranged now for every week from now till then. And training once a week. And that. So it's hard with football. There's football championship on at the minute. So all the bad lads play football. So it's just hard to get a night that suits everybody. But we're still at it anyway. Working hard.
And you're playing Monaghan, so what's the team from Monaghan?
It's true, girls, so it is. There'll be an Art Monaghan club, Emmyvale and on up there. And we'd know them well, particularly at underage level. Cootehill play in the Monaghan leagues and that, so we'd know them well. And there would be good rivalry. We would have met them before in under-16 finals and minor finals and that, and they've beaten us and we've beaten them. So it's just the look of the draw of their team we'd know well, but... you know, it's going to be a good match. Yeah. It'll be a great game. I don't know where it's going to be fixed yet, but it'll be a great game. And obviously, because Calvin Monaghan again, it'll be good local rivalry and that. So,
yeah,
you know, it should be a good game.
Exactly, as you're saying. You can't get more local with Cootehill. I suppose bordering Monaghan.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it's always, it'll be an interesting game. And what is this Monaghan team? You know, what do you know about them? Like, I mean, how strong a team are they? Or, you know, have you kind of...
Well, to be honest with you, to be very similar to ourselves, to be a well-run club, good underage setup. They'd be supplying a lot of lads there to Monaghan, you know, the under-16s and the minors and that kind of crack. So there'd be an awful lot, you know, of parallels between the two clubs and the way we're running that. And the fellas that would be coaching them would be still playing themselves, just the same as Aiden here. Like, you know, Aiden coaches a lot in Cootehill and that kind of crack and obviously still plays himself. And that, so it'd be very similar, you know, similar type of club and that. Well run, good lads, good club.
Very good. So then that's, I suppose, the next round. What about, you know, underage hurling in the club? Have you much involvement with that at the younger levels?
Aiden will have a lot.
Well, I have a bit. There's other lads like Gabriel Shalvey, Lona McKenna, Gary Kieran, Kevin O'Carney, Pauline Shalvey, and others that's... are big involved in it. So far this year they've won under-14, under-16, minor. We were joined in the Monaghan League, so there's a Monaghan League and a Cavan League.
Right, yeah.
So we have at least 5 or 6 cups won on the underage scene, and hopefully we'll get another one or two before the year's out.
You've probably seen a huge turnaround in I suppose, their ability. And a lot of kids, I suppose, they love playing the dual sports. They're happy to play the Gaelic and the hurling.
Yep.
I suppose that's probably a huge push in the county, I suppose, towards that now. You said as well that I suppose your team is made up of not just obviously primarily, not like the Gaelic football where it is your Cootehill and that's it, but it takes in the catchment area. What kind of other clubs is kind of involved in Cootehill?
Well, I suppose like myself and Aiden are a perfect example. Like, you know, Aiden would be Kill, I'd be Drung. We'd also have lads from Drungoon, Knockbride, and that, you know what I mean? So it's basically, it's Drung, Kill, Cootehill, and Knockbride, Drungoon.
Yes.
That would be our mostly, to be honest with you, it'd be very, almost like St. Aidan's, like the comprehensive. Like a lot of the lads would go to school together, so we would know each other that way.
Yeah, okay, so
it works well that way. And obviously then St. Aidan's, you know, have done well. They've won the junior and the senior this year as well, so... Yeah. You know what I mean? That would be another asset, obviously, for the club. Like, you know what
Brilliant.
I mean?
And you have the cup here, but and I'm sure there was. You're obviously the captain, so you got to lift that cup. Was it a great moment in front of your
powerful.
Family and friends?
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah,
it was great.
What one to remember? And I know Cavan TV, we were present, and there is some footage from that day. And where was the final? It was
in
Breffni Park.
Yeah, yeah.
So it was. So training, I suppose, if anyone is watching and, you know, watching this and think, oh, I'd like to get involved, I'd like to join the club, and, you know, knowing that there is a hurling club, you know, when is training, how can they get involved, Seamus?
Well, I suppose the easiest thing is probably to check the Facebook page, because you know, because we're working at so many levels, like we're working from, you know, under eights right up to senior, that's the best way to find out. Or obviously the notes in the Anglo-Celt and that, you know what I mean? Because there's you know, most nights there'll be some type of, you know, hurling going on. So, you know, for the different age groups, you know what I mean? So I'm not going to tie myself down on times now because,
it,
you know.
It changes with football. If, you know, football could be football on tonight, so we have to change hurling to another night. So we all work together, so.
Yeah.
Facebook is the best way.
Yeah.
And so, of course, yeah, I suppose if anybody, sorry, Dave. Yeah, so if if you want to contact the show about anything, just contact us on Twitter at Cavan TV Sport or Cavan Television. Actually, we're there on Twitter also. And we do have a video coming up any moment now. Is that right? Great. So I just, Seamus and Aiden, yeah, thank you very much for coming and speaking to us. Is there anyone you'd like to thank, Aiden, or you know, any sponsors or any of that you have?
We have sponsors. Colum Smith's Dental is our sponsor. So thanks very much to them.
Looking after the pearly whites.
We didn't lose any this year so far. But just a few people. Mick Roach is a great ambassador there for the club, who played back with me in the 80s or so. And Mick Delaney, I'd like to remember him. He was a great player for Cavan and Cootehill. And this cup's all about those sort of people, you know.
Lovely. That's really nice. That's
and great. I suppose myself, just to appreciate like the clubs, the feeder clubs and that kind of crack, and it's particularly football people, you know what I mean? That, you know, the loud boys come in and play with us and understand, and they can see themselves, you know, as the boys, you know, discipline and skill of hurling, you know, it, you know, can translate into football. So, you know, we've a good relationship with the football clubs in the area, which is great.
Which is great. Well, Seamus and Aiden, thank you for joining us on All About Sport. And let's relive the moment that Cootehill Celtic won the Cavan Senior Hurling Championship in Breffni Park. Check this out. And when we come back, I'll be out on the street outside the Cavan TV studios ready for my ice bucket challenge. So make sure to stay tuned for that.
Wrong fucking time coming.
Were you even married when you started playing? You've been the best man 23 years ago today.
These are the men to show here. Brian, these lads here, this is the place to won it. This is the place.
Thank you. few years' time will have more senior teams competing for the Senior Hurling Championship. Well, just now I want to present the cup, the Annie Brady Cup, to the head captain, Aiden Fitzpatrick.
Thank you.
So you're very welcome back to studio. As you can see, I am ready and willing to do my ice bucket challenge. So you're going to have to follow us out onto the street where I can undertake this challenge. So here we go. Are we ready? I'm all prepared. So first, I'd like to thank my guests. I'm just leaving them behind in the studio. And I have the team of Cavan TV Studios out on the street. Not nervous at all, Paul Cox. Got lots of ice for me. So, here we go. Now, right, do I use this mic? Okay, here we go. Right, I have to remember what to say. Hello and welcome to Louise O'Reilly's Ice Bucket Challenge. Yes, I am here on the street outside Cavan TV Studios in Cavan Town. First, I'd like to thank the Top of the Town pub for donating the bucket of ice. Secondly, I'd like to thank Orla McDonald, Jane McGuinness and Cavan Comets for the challenge, and I accept. I wish to challenge and I want to nominate the rest of the gang here at Cavan TV who have yet to undertake the challenge. So anyone from Cavan TV, if you haven't done the challenge, you have to take it. So I see a great candidate. Also, I want to nominate, oh my gosh, who else? Oh yes, Get Rhythm. The remaining members of Get Rhythm, a tribute to Johnny Cash. I want to nominate last week's guest, John Joe Nevin. And I wish to nominate Aegon O'Farrell, president-elect of GAA. So, I'm going to give this microphone over to Tina, and here we go. Next Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. Be sure to tune in. Goodbye from me, Louise O'Reilly. Woo.